Hi everyone. In the following experiment, we investigate the question of how to make a magnet from an ordinary iron nail and then demagnetize the magnetized iron nail again. First, I try to pick up an iron paperclip with the iron nail. As you can see, with rather moderate success. Hear the whole thing again in the animation. To get an idea of why you can't pick up a paperclip with a non-magnetized iron nail, let's take a look inside the nail and the paperclip. First, let's look at a self-made model of an iron nail. Let us assume that there are a lot of small bore magnets in the iron nail to explain why an ordinary iron nail has no magnetic effect on the outside. These small magnets are called elementary magnets. However, this is only a simplified model and not the actual structure of a magnet. The elementary magnets are arranged in such a way that as many south poles as north poles point in all directions. As a result, the magnetic forces balance each other, and the iron nail has no external magnetic force to attract the paperclip. A look inside the paperclip shows us that the elementary magnets are also aligned here so that the paperclip has no magnetic effect on the outside. Let's go back to the real experiment. You see that a magnet can be used to lift an iron paperclip. What's the difference between a magnet and our iron nail? Let's look at the structure of a magnet in the model. As you can see in the bar magnet, more north poles of the elementary magnets point downwards than upwards. This unequal alignment of the elementary magnets ensures that the bar magnet has a north pole at the lower end. The magnetic force of the north pole now ensures that some elementary magnets in the paperclip are aligned with their south pole facing up. The north pole of the magnet and the newly created south pole of the paperclip are now facing each other. And as you already know, unequal magnetic poles attract. Now I stroke the iron nail with the north pole of the magnet always in a certain direction. Now I can lift the paperclip with this iron nail even if it would not have had contact with the bar magnet before. What happens when the magnet is swept over the iron nail? Let's look at this in the animation. The north pole of the bar magnet with its magnetic force ensures that some elementary magnets in the iron nail align with their south poles towards the north pole of the bar magnet. Now in the iron nail, more elementary magnets point with their south pole downwards than upwards. The nail thus has a magnetic south pole at its tip. The south pole of the nail and the north pole of the bar magnet attract each other. Even if the bar magnet is now removed from the iron nail, the orientation of the elementary magnets in the iron nail remains, so that the nail still has a north and a south pole. Now you can lift the paperclip with a magnetized nail. Now I hold the tip of the iron nail in the flame of a candle for a long time and try again to lift the paperclip with the nail. As you can see, again with moderate success. What happens to the magnetized iron nail when you hold it in the candle flame? First of all, the elementary magnets are aligned so that more south poles point towards the tip. However, the warmth of the candle ensures that the elementary magnet starts to move and align themselves so that the same number of south and north poles point towards the tip of the nail. As a result, the iron nail again appears non-magnetic to the outside. The iron nail was demagnetized. It is no longer able to pick up a non-magnetized paperclip.